can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Go tell that long-tongued liar. Go and tell that midnight rider. Tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter. Tell them that God's gonna cut them down. Tell them that God's gonna cut them down.
Hello, and you are driving home with your host, Richard Haas, for the Friday edition of Drive Time Apologetics. This podcast is for March 3rd, 2017. Well, I was going to talk about Lent today, but I think we're going to hold off to that on that subject for early next week's podcast. And just a little side note, there will be no podcast tomorrow. Normally, we, or I, record on Saturday. However, this Saturday, I have stuff going on, and I have to be someplace early. Therefore, I'm leaving work early, and I won't be doing a podcast, so I won't be able to record because I gotta pick somebody up right from the time I leave from work and give them a ride to where we need to be. So there will be no Drive Time Apologetics tomorrow. Now, with that said, let's dive right into today's topic. Like I said, I was going to talk about Lent. I was going to discuss Lent. I was going to give you reasons why Protestants and Christians in general do not need to celebrate Lent. That Lent is not for those, for Protestants, for Bible-believing Christians. But something else came up, and I want to discuss it. And if you follow me over on Facebook at Richard Haas, you can follow me there. And you'll see what I posted over there. And it has to deal with what was posted in our local newspaper, or local news TV station. And it was in our local newspaper, too. But the post I posted and shared was dealing with, from our local news affiliate here, CBS 58 out of Milwaukee, dealing with the new Beauty and Beast movie that's coming out. There's a new Beauty and a Beast movie, a remake, a redone, a redo, whatever you want to, you know, how they're redoing everything and all the movies of late. Well, the problem is, and the issue with this redone movie of the Beauty and the Beast is that it is going to be, for the first time, Disney is going to be featuring a openly gay. And I hate using the term gay, because gay means happy. So let's use the correct term. And I really don't want to use the political correct term that society calls it, of homosexuality. So let's put it as what it is and call it as it the act of the sin what it is. And let's not save words on it or pierce words on this. Let's call it what it is. They're going to be featuring a openly sodomite character. That character's name is Lefou, and he's one of the main characters in Beauty and Beast, if you remember. You know, it's been years since I've read Beauty and Beast, watched the old cartoon version or animated version of Beauty and Beast. I think last time I've watched Beauty and the Beast, I don't have girls, I have boys, so it was a very short introduction. I think they saw it once when they were 4 or 5, so that was about 10 years ago, so give or take. But what they're going to be doing in this movie is they're going to have an openly gay or openly sodomite character, Lefou. And he is going to be spreading his sodomite-ness all over the screen. And it's going to be highly emphasized from what I can gather from the articles I have read. And it's going to be highly publicized. Now, the LGBTQ, Y, X, Z, N, 1, 2, 3 crowd is proclaiming this as an advancement in their so-called cause or their agenda. And don't get me wrong, the homosexuals or the sodomites, the LGBTQXYZ and NMOP crowd does have an agenda. I actually got in an extensive argument on the page that this was posted on Facebook, on the CBS 58 page. I'm surprised I haven't been kicked off of there yet because of the things I say in defiance of the normalities that are trying to be pushed in news media and society. But I outright posted that, you know, hey, this is an offense. It's actually a push or a trial and trying of to undermine not only the Christian worldview, but the unit of a family. Meaning that, you know, the established unit of a family. And what I mean by that is the established family, man and woman. This is an outright just underlie, you know, smack dang right into the face, you know, of parents. Handed right to you parents on a silver platter to indoctrinate your kids. Well, of course, that, you know, just, you know, started, you know, the replies after replies. Last time I checked, here's the thing. I'm not going to answer all these replies because a lot of it's just stupefaction. Just people are stupid. I don't even, stupefaction, it's a word I made up. But, you know, it's just, it's the outright just stupidity of the unregenerate. The comments that people make. You know, oh, you're a hater, you're this, you're that. And, you know, they're just, you know, the contradictions they say, or, well, the Bible says this, what should we kill? You know, all these different things they say. You know, and I'm not going to sit there and argue with them, because last time I checked, I think it was up to, like, 183 comments or replies under my thing. Whole bunch of likes. I think it was, like, 100 and 200 likes I got on a thing, or on a statement from people. But, you know, of course, they're going to have your people in disagreement, and all they can do is offer non-biased statements, and really just statements that have no proof or warrant any real response, because they're not coming from a biblical stance, they're coming from a humanistic stance, because they're unregenerate. And sometimes you have to know when to, for say, roll in the mud with the pigs, and sometimes you need just to know when not to comment, because it's not worth it. You said what you needed to say, and people are going to say what they think they need to say in response. But now, getting back to the movie and us as Christian parents, we have to, as Christian parents, I've talked about this, I talked about this in yesterday's show, we have to realize that Hollywood tries to market to individuals and groups or demographics. They're not individually marketing to segments of society, quote, like Christians because they want to produce Christian material, little kids because they want to produce little kid material. There is an agenda behind it. The agenda is money. Whoever is funding and giving the most money, and wherever they think, or the demographic that they are going to give or get or receive the most money for their productions, they're going to do so. So this is why they're doing this with, at least Disney is, because they want to push the LGBTQ, XYMO, 123, MNLP, whatever, you know, you want to call it, agenda down the road. They want to, you know, roll the ball down the road, you know, and that is exactly why they're doing it. Disney has made no qualms in the past, and it's been kind of hidden, skirted around in many of the shows you see on, produced by Disney, on the Disney Channel, and that, in the support of homosexuality, transgenderism, various other, you know, depraved and perverted lifestyles they are trying to normalize. But this is the first time they've taken and just outright put it in a child's movie. So we have to, you know, as parents, guard our kids from this. I know if I had kids that were interested or of the age to see that type of movie, not going to happen. They're not going to see the remake of Beauty and the Beast. And as parents, concerned parents, and if you're listening to this as a Christian parent or as a non-Christian parent, maybe you're tuning into this for the first time and you're like, hey, what is Drive Time Apologetics checking out? Maybe you're not a believer. Here's the thing. You need to still safeguard your children. You put locks on your house. right? You lock your door at night to safeguard your children. You just don't want people coming in and abducting and messing with your family and whatever, you know. So you put boundaries, you put locks on your doors to protect your family. In the same regard, we have to put locks on what our family views and guard what our family sees. And especially children. We cannot expose children to this type of indoctrination. And don't get me wrong, when I say this, because I mean exactly what I'm going to say here, that the LGBTQ crowd, the Gestapo, as I sometimes call them, if you're not familiar with that reference, it goes back to the Gestapo of World War II, which were the Nazi police, but the Gestapo of today, they have an agenda. Their agenda is to normalize their perversion and to make normal union between man and woman, heterosexual relations, the outside view. They want to normalize their sodomy, their sin.